Level number one, people follow you because they have to. And level number two, people will follow you because they want to. I can always tell in a company when people are at level number one with their overseers versus as if they're level number two. I mean, let me tell you the difference. At level number one, if you're leading people on level number one, the question people ask all the time while they're following you is, how little do I have to do and not be fired? They're looking for the least that they have to do. At level number one, I can always tell, because if I'm in a company where their leaders are not very good leaders, and they're all at level number one, and if the quitting time is at 5 o'clock, you go through the offices of level number one leaders, and you go through the, you know what? The desk is cleared at 4:45. Yeah. In fact, at 4:45, all the work is done. It's all put away. And all the people that work there have their tennis shoes on. And they're in a three-point stance. And they're watching that clock. And at 5 o'clock, they're gone. 5:01, every car is out of the parking lot. Because at level number one, people only follow you because they have to. At level number two, what happens? Now they like you. They want to follow you. You have a relationship with them. This is where synergy begins to build. At level number two, people will give you extra time. At 5 o'clock, if you're in the middle of a project, they're still working on the project because they like you. They like being with you. You're doing this thing together, and away you go. So, at level number two, it's a wonderful level to be on because you like the people like you, and the relationship now has begun to build. I sometimes call this the second mile level. This is extra effort is at level number two. Minimal effort is at level number one. But there's a higher level than level number two. The third level of leadership is the production level. The production level. At level number three, the key word is results. At level number three, people follow you because of what you have done for the organization. At level number three, now people will follow you because they look at you and they see that you have done some wonderful things for the company. And in fact, they'll look at you and they'll say, oh my goodness, you know, since they joined the company has doubled its profits, the company has increased its client base. And when you're at level number three, they talk of you in terms of great endearment because they not only like you because you're on level number two with them, but on level number three, now they say, this person's done a lot for the organization. So they follow you because of what you have produced. It's a wonderful level beyond, by the way. When you're on level number three, you're still on level number two. And you're still on level one. You're building a foundation now under your leadership. So when you get to level number three, you don't leave level two. In other words, you don't get to level number three and say, boy, am I glad that I'm off of level number two. I don't have to like people anymore. This is going to be so good. Woo! I was so tired of being nice to the people. You don't leave the level, you build on the levels. So when you're on level number three, you've got level three, two, and one underneath you. Now you're building a foundation under your leadership. Now, it's at level number three where people follow you because of what you have done for the organization. It's at level number three that momentum kicks in. It's at level number three that all of a sudden your company, your department, is absolutely, you've got what I call the big mo. You've got the big mo going for you. You've got the momentum going for you. And it's a wonderful level to be on. Because let me tell you something, the best friend of a leader is momentum. Because when you have momentum as a leader, everything is exaggerated in a positive way. When you have that momentum as a leader, everybody talks about you, about how good it's going and how good you are. Can I just say that when you've got the big mo going for you, people think you are better than you really are. And that's a good thing. They'll say, whoa, awesome. awesome leader. Oh my, just an incredible leader. Well, you're not that good. But you have a momentum going for you. You see, when momentum is against you, when it's negative, can I tell you something? You're worse than people think you are. So momentum exaggerates you either to better or to worse. It exaggerates you positively or it exaggerates you negatively. And let me tell you something about momentum. Momentum is the greatest problem solver in your company. If you really want to solve problems, get momentum. Momentum will solve many more problems than anything else in your organization because momentum is a problem solver. Let me explain. A train going 55 miles an hour down on a track, that train going 55 miles an hour down on a track can smash through a 5-foot-thick concrete steel reinforced wall and just keep on going because it has momentum. It hits that wall, smashes it, and just keeps going. The engineer looks at his buddy and says, did we hit something back there? Well, what allowed it to get through the wall? It was momentum that allowed it. That same train without momentum stopped dead on its tracks. If you put a 1-inch block in front of its driving wheel, that same train can't even get started. Think about it. With momentum, a 5-foot-thick concrete steel reinforced wall can be broken. Without momentum, that train can't even get started with a 1-inch problem. So when people come to me and they'll say, the problem in our organization is we got all these problems, and because of all these problems, we're just not having a very good year, and I just want you to know that problems are overrated and the momentum is underrated. On level number three, if you can get to level number three, you're going to be able to knock down most of the problems in your life. In fact, I tell people all the time, the problem is not the problem. The problem is they don't know that the problem is not the problem. And so the problem that is not the problem becomes a problem. Not because it is a problem, but the problem is they didn't know it wasn't a problem. So now that the problem that wasn't a problem has become a problem, and now they have a problem that they didn't have if they would have known that the problem wasn't the problem. Because the problem was they didn't know the problem wasn't the problem, that now the problem that wasn't a problem has become the problem, and now they have a real problem because the problem was they didn't know the problem wasn't a problem. Some melancholics raise their hand. Excuse me. Could you repeat that one more time? By the way, managers try to solve problems. Leaders try to create momentum. What leaders know is if you can create more momentum in your organization, 90% of the problems that will ever pop up will be solved. Not because you're a great problem solver, not because you're smart. Most of the problems will be solved because you have momentum. Momentum solves problems, and managers are always trying to fix problems, and leaders are trying to create the momentum. They realize that 90% of the problems you have can be fixed if you can just get on level three. Level three is a wonderful level to be on. It's a wonderful level to lead people on, because if you're on this level and you're leading them on this level, it becomes absolutely amazing what you're going to accomplish. But there's a higher level. In fact, all of my books that I write, all of my lectures that I give and teaching, I do because my goal is to get the people to the level number four. Now, I know there are five levels. But all I've got to do is get you to level four. If you can get to level four on your own, the people that work with you will put you on level five. So you don't need to worry about level five. You don't need to worry about that for several reasons. One is you're not there, so don't worry about it. Okay. My name is John. I'm your friend. Okay. Okay. Level number four is what I call the personhood level. No, it isn't. No. It isn't that. I'm sorry. It's not that at all. Okay. Excuse me. That's level five. Okay. I'm a leader, but I have no clue. Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. Excuse me. I'm laughing at myself. Level four. By the way, when you make mistakes, laugh at yourself. Everybody else is. Join them. Okay. Don't just be by yourself. Okay. Level number four is the people development level. The people development level. The key word here is reproduction. At level number four, you're now reproducing people and reproducing leaders. And the key word is, at level three, they follow you because of what you've done for the organization. At level number four, they follow you because of what you have done for them. In other words, at level three, you've changed the organization. But at level number four, you've changed them. Now, this is an incredible level to be on. When you're on level number three, people are saying, it's amazing what he or she has done to the department since she's been there. Everything is so much better. But when you're level number four, they not only talk about what you've done for the organization, you want to start a talk and say, let me tell you what that person has done for me. I joined this company 3.5 years ago. They began to mentor me. They began to develop me. They began to equip and train me. And I'm here to tell you, I'm a better person because of them. I'm a better leader because of them. I learned how to lead. I had 3 pay raises because I'm getting productive. And now they're talking about you, and they're talking to you about the fact that you not only helped the organization, you've helped them. Now, let me tell you something. At level number four, loyalty kicks in big time. This is where they go to the mat for you. I mean, at level number four, they say, oh, my goodness, let me tell you something. I'm going to be loyal to this individual because look what they have done it for me. And then this is a wonderful level to be on. And what I do is I try to teach leadership in such a way that I help people learn how to develop people. So therefore, I write books on teamwork. I write books on how to lead. Because if you can develop people, if you can raise up people, if you can find them, recruit them, raise them up, develop them into the leaders, the world will be yours. Because now you're reproducing everything. At level three, everything is addition. At level number four, everything is multiplication. Why? Because at level three, you're still having to touch everything to make it work. At level four, the people that you have trained and developed are also teaching and touching and multiplying. And so now all of a sudden, you're looking at everything and it's beginning. It's just like, oh my goodness, I can't believe how fast we're beginning to grow. What happened? Many hands make light work. Level number four is that level where you're developing people. I have spent my entire life at level number four. I've spent all my life trying to develop people. In fact, my whole thing is, I own 2 companies still. And my whole thing has been, I'm going to raise up people and let them get in leadership positions, and then I'm going to give them a job. In fact, what I tell them is, I'm going to develop you, equip you, and I'm going to expect you, I'm going to work myself out of a job. I'm going to work myself out of a job. And don't worry about me. When I work myself out of this job, I'll go find another one. So don't relax. Take a pill. But then what I tell people is, your job now is to work your way out of a job. In fact, here's what I tell them. If you'll train and equip people to work your way out of a job, I'll give you another job. But if you can't train and equip people to work your way out of the job you got, I'm going to take it away from you. Because what my goal in life is to help people train, develop, equip people until those people can carry on those responsibilities. Now, it's at level number four that you begin to train leaders. It's at level number four that you begin to develop a good team. It's at level number four that people begin to have a greater self-worth because they're getting better. Why are they getting better? Because of how you have helped them get better. You're now really adding value to people. Now, there's one more level, and I want to do 2 or 3 thoughts about that. Then we'll take a quick break. At level number one, the position level, people follow you because you have certain rights. They have to. And level two is relationships. Now they're following you because they like you or because they want to. Level three is production. The key word is results. They now are following you because of what you've done for the organization. And level number four, you're now developing people. The key word is reproduction. And they're following you because of what you have done for them. Now notice this. If you're on level four, you're also with the people on level three, two, and one. So you're reproducing people. You're doing good for the organization. People like you. And then you have a position. Now, if you do those 4 things extremely well, one day the people, you don't do this for yourself, one day the people will put you on a level 5. That level is the personhood level. And personhood level, the key word there is respect. And at level number 5, you have helped so many people so well for so long that now you're bigger than life. And they have put you in a position of respect that you could enjoy the rest of your life. Now, as I've taught you these five levels of leadership, let's look at it for a second. Let's look at these steps. Because if I were sitting where you are, and I would be taking notes, and I would be looking at these steps. I know I don't have the gift of artistry, but keep it there, okay. See, I'd be looking at these five levels, and I would be asking my mind, the question you should be asking yourself right now, and I would almost guarantee many of you are, you're asking yourself, what level am I on with the people I lead? Isn't that true? You're looking at, am I on level one, or am I on level two, or am I on level three? And if you are here with somebody that you work with, or that is your overseer, you're probably right now looking at yourself and saying, well, what level am I on with the leader? Now, what I want you to see about this is a couple, two or three things. If you ask yourself what level you're on with the people in your organization, the first thing you're going to discover is this, and see if this is not true. The first thing you're going to discover is you're not on the same level with everybody in your organization. Is that not true? Talk to me for a moment. Thank you. In other words, if somebody just new has come into your organization or department, it's highly probable you're on level number one. Isn't that true? You haven't had time to develop relationships with them. They don't know how good you are. They don't know what you've done for the company. You certainly haven't had any time to develop them. So for new people, you're probably on level one. Now, hopefully for people that have been in your organization for a little bit, you've developed a relationship with. So now they like you. You like them. Kumbaya all the time. Okay, here we go. Where are the levels? Thank you. So for some, you're on level number two. And you say, okay, this is good. I'm on level number two. You're on you know, let's say, for example, let's say you have 10 people in your department. With all 10 people, you're on level number one. But on level number two, you may only be on level number two with about seven of them. In fact, the higher you go, the less people will be on the level with you. Now, on level number three, because some have been with you and have seen some success for a while, on level number three, you may be on that level with five of the 10. So, and on level number four, maybe you've only developed two of them. So you're on level with 10 out of the 10, you've got two of them on level four that are with you. Now, talk to me for a minute. Because this is a 3-hour lecture I'm trying to do in 30 minutes. Give me feedback. Do you understand what I'm saying here? Look at the person beside you and say, I understand what he's saying. Go ahead and tell him. Thank you. In fact, look at that person and say, and why don't you understand this? Now, here's what I want you to see. You're not on the same level with everybody in your department. Makes sense? Yes or no? Okay, you got it. Now, here we go. Here's what I want you to see. People follow you based on what level they're on with you. So people don't follow you the same. People receive your vision or your dream based upon what level you're on. So therefore, if you get up in front of your people and say, okay, I want to talk to you about, okay, we're going to relocate. We're going to make some changes in this company. Now, let me tell you something. When you say I'm going to make changes in the company, people on level number one, they don't have much allegiance to you. They're not going to change with you. They're looking at you. They're crossing their arms, and I don't want to do that. People on level number four, they've been with you for long enough. You've got a relationship with them. They've watched you be successful in the company. You've developed them. See, at level number four, there's a lot more commitment at level number four. There's a lot more willingness to change. Some people ask me all the time, they'll say, John, I stood up in front of the same group of people on the same day in the same company, and I cast the same vision, and I got five different reactions. Why? It's very simple. People receive the vision based upon what level they're on with you. By the way, that's why you can't lead everybody the same. You lead people much differently on level number one than you do that are on level number two. You have to know which level they're on. And so here's your exercise. In fact, this is an incredible exercise for you. I wish I had time to walk you through it, because you're the smartest crowd I've talked to today. So you can walk through it yourself. I would encourage you, I don't know, sometime this week, don't let this week pass without doing this exercise. List the people that you lead. And then ask the question, what level are they on with you? Are they a level one person? Are they level four? and put names with the levels. And then look at how you're going to have to lead them. For example, the higher you go, the easier it is to lead. You don't even have to prove your leadership to people on level number 4. They've been in with you for so long, they see you do it so well. Why don't you say, let's go? They just get up and say, let's go. Why did they say that? Because they've watched you, they've observed you. See, the higher you go, the easier it is to lead. So, the more people you have on higher levels, the easier it is to lead them. That's why leadership in the beginning is very difficult, because you haven't established yourself. You haven't established what level that you're going to be on. How are we doing? Go back to the levels one more time. Yeah, I'm almost done, but not quite. Here's what I want you to see. People, let's say with most people, you're on level number 3. There you are. Never looked better. Now, it's very possible as a leader that you'll make a big mistake. Maybe you make a wrong decision. Perhaps you make something that will cost the company something. Okay, now here's what I want you to understand. If you're on level number 3 with most of the people, you may fall a little bit. But if you fall, you've got the next level to catch you. Does that make sense? Now, if you are just a positional leader, and you've never increased your leadership strength any more than that, and let's say you're on level number 1. When you make a mistake, this is not a good thing. You're now out of the organization. In the United States, when you happen to move, you're called U-Haul. I tell people in the States, if they're on level number 1, they're one step from U-Haul. The higher you go, the more cushion you have under your leadership. That's why when people that are very good